My name is James, but since there's so many other guys named James, I sometimes call James the Little or James the Less. Since I'm shorter than most of the other guys named James. And my father's name was Alphaeus, but sometimes they call me James the Son of Alphaeus. My family's a problem. We can trace our ancestry all the way back to the tribe of Gad, one of the 12 sons of Jacob. I'll never forget the day that I first saw the Master. I was walking down the road near the place where John was baptizing, so I went over there for a closer look. Then I saw Jesus asking John to baptize him. Well, at first John refused, but Jesus insisted. And afterwards, the sun, the sky opened up, and the Lord came down on Jesus in the form of a dove, and we heard a voice from heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." At the end of the first year of his public ministry, he chose me to be one of the 12 apostles. And since that day, I prayed with him and stayed with him and walked with him and talked with him, trying to learn as much about him and his Heavenly Father as I could. And now, we just came from the supper in the upper room there, and he told us that one of us is to betray him. How can that be? The betrayer must be out of his mind. And I'm like all the rest of the apostles, I keep asking myself, is it I? Is it I?
Chief priests and the Jewish leaders came to him. They wanted a favor. because they don't like my husband. But they came to him, and I don't know if you know my husband, but he's rather a grumpy man. And he was especially irritated because they came so early. Apparently they had someone in custody, someone named Jesus, and they wanted him put to death. And they needed my husband's help. So, my husband agreed. He went to them. He listened to them. He asked questions. He asked Jesus questions. He said, I see no reason why he should be put to death. I'll have him punished, and then I'm going to release him. This is about the time I had intervened. I sent to him a message. I said, do not have anything to do with that innocent man. I have suffered all day because of this in a dream. So he said he'd punish him, and then he would have him released. Apparently there's some custom during the Passover that a prisoner is released. I think the Jewish council had persuaded the crowd because the crowd started yelling, Barabbas! Barabbas! Release Barabbas! Pilate said, what would you have me do with the king of the Jews? Crucify! Crucify! The crowd was getting irate. My husband was afraid there was going to be a riot, and if you know my husband, a riot's the last thing he wanted, especially with Herod in town. So, he got some water, he washed his hands, and he said, I am innocent of this man's blood. It is your responsibility. And he sent his guards out to him and had him stripped and he had him flogged and they sent him away and the Jewish people had him tortured and they made fun of him and they mocked him and then they placed nails in his hands and his feet and they hung him on a cross to die.
Thank you. And The others were angry and heard her request. Jesus then reminded us that he who would be first must be the servant of all. He demonstrated his words tonight just before supper by washing our feet. Once, when the people of a certain Samaritan village did not receive Jesus as we thought they should, we asked him to call down the fire from heaven, destroy them. But he rebuked us, as only he could, and taught us that God's way is always one of love. And now, he who taught us the way of love is to be betrayed by one of those whom he loves? How can that be? Why should one of us do such a thing? I keep thinking in my own heart, is it I? Is it I?